This is a role play developed as part of the course curriculum for Manage TB, an online course for doctors. The participants have enacted the roles given to them. The case discussed does not refer to any existing patient, but has been developed as part of the course curriculum. The investigations, such as x-rays and lab reports, used in this case scenario belongs to patients treated at National Institute for Research in Tuberculosis, Chennai. Their identity have been anonymized.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yeah, good morning, doctor.
Ma'am, I have a case to discuss.
Yes, we can discuss it now.
Ma'am, there is a child, 5 years old child. The mother reports the following, ma'am. He's having persistent fever for 1 week, which is intermittent in nature. For the past 2 months, he's not eating well and he's not gained any weight. And he often has repeated respiratory tract infections.
Have you collected any more additional information?
Yes, ma'am. The child did not have any TB treatment in the past. There is no history of contact with TB patients either in the family or among their relatives. The child is immunized appropriately for his age. The child's HIV status is not known, but the mother is not reactive for HIV and the child has not received any blood transfusion. I have done a thorough general and systematic examination. The child is febrile, not dyspneic. The auscultation of hearts and lungs are normal and there is no organomegaly.
So, if you are considering a TB diagnosis in this child, so what are the additional investigations we will be doing in this child?
Ma'am, if the child is able to produce sputum, I will order for an expert for the sputum. And if the child is not able to produce sputum, I will go for an induced sputum or order for an early morning gastric aspirate, which should be done on an empty stomach. And this aspirate should be sent for expert. Suppose if expert is not available, then sputum smear for AFP should be ordered. Then I heard that bacteriological confirmation diagnosis of TB in children is difficult. So, is it so, ma'am?
Yes, you're correct. The bacteriological confirmation in children is difficult because they do not produce sputum. And also the sensitivity of the available test on the gastric aspirate is low.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, what about blood serology? Will it help in the diagnosis of TB in children?
No, serological tests are not recommended for diagnosis. In diagnosis of TB. Both the WHO and the Indian guidelines has emphasized that the commercially available serological tests are not reliable and should not be used for the diagnosis of TB.
What other tests can I order for this child to diagnose TB, ma'am?
So you can do a chest x-ray in this child. So chest x-ray is a complementary diagnostic tool in the diagnosis of TB. However, like all the abnormalities in the chest x-ray are not suggestive of TB. But in children, chest x-ray may be helpful in diagnosis.
Then what about MANTO test? I heard one of my friends doing MANTO for a child in a ward. What about it, ma'am?
Yeah, the tuberculin skin test is commonly referred to as MANTO. And you are aware that the positive MANTO is suggestive of a TB infection and not TB disease. Okay. However, in the absence of bacteriological confirmation, a positive MANTO test can help in diagnosis of TB in children.
Okay. Then what will be the confirmatory test for pulmonary TB in children?
Yeah, the confirmatory test for pulmonary TB in children will be a gastric aspirate or a sputum positivity of AFB and or a gene expert positivity.
Then how will I diagnose TB in the case of absence of any bacteriological confirmation?
So in the absence of bacteriological confirmation, you have to do a chest x-ray, a TST and also evaluate the child for any alternate diagnosis. Then you have to repeat the chest x-ray after a course of antibiotics.
Okay.
And if still the symptoms, still the x-ray have got lesions, it is suggestive of clinically diagnosed TB.
Okay.
And in the absence, if the child doesn't have any bacteriological confirmation, with the strong suspicion of clinical futures, MANTO positivity can help in the diagnosis of TB in children.
Okay, ma'am.
Can you summarize the key points in the diagnosis of TB in children?
Early morning gastric aspirate to be done on empty stomach in a child unable to produce sputum. Serological tests are not recommended for the diagnosis of TB in children and adults. Chest X-ray is a complementary and an important diagnostic tool in pulmonary TB in children. Positive manto is indicative of TB infection and not TB disease. TST can be used to guide treatment in children.